Well, hello and welcome to Henry's Band in the Box channel. That's right. No long intro today, right? This is a short one here. But back in the day, you know, at Motown, they had a philosophy. And the philosophy was about intros, right? And Berry Gordy's position was that you had to grab the listener in the first four or eight bars, right? You know, and they put a lot of songs out, and if you listen to those songs, right, you'll see how they grab the audience, like, you know, like David Ruffin, right? I know you wanna leave me, but I refuse. You know, once you hear that, man, it's got you, right? You know, so the days of the then, they've come back around again. Think about TikTok or YouTube videos where the limit is 30 seconds. And most of them, you only have 15 seconds. And the reason why is because in a fast society like this, you have to grab the listener really, really quickly. So this is something short, but it's about intros because it's all about trying to grab that listener right from the beginning. And what most of us do is most of us, we have our eight-bar intro. I know because I do it too, right? We have our long, drawn-out eight-bar intro, right, you know, and the listener's already like before we even get started, right? But there's a tool in Band in the Box that will help you generate an intro, and it might make your song a bit more interesting, right? So here we go, right? I'm going to do this, right? Again, today is about intros, and intros. So what I have a song I call Lonely in a Crowd that I wrote. It's been a few months, maybe 12 months ago, right? But it had a nice intro to it, right? And I was trying to think of one when I put the song together, but I really couldn't come up with anything. I knew I didn't want the intro. The intro started like, the original intro started just like this. Just like this, right? It's got these background vocals going in the intro. Bars now saying, I still hear the sound of the children playing. So I said, okay, well, you know what? That's kind of cool, right? But at the same time, it doesn't build up. It just starts to hit you in the face. Ah, right? It's like, you know, hit you right in the face, right? So I said, I need an intro. And if you're like a lot of people, right, a lot of us, what do? We just take the same part of the initial verse, and we add four or eight bars of just music. So I said, I didn't want that here, right? I wanted something a little bit different. So I asked Band in the Box, right, to help me out. And it's a nice tool in here that will do that for you. So the tool is called Intro. It will generate an intro for you. So I went to Songform. I went to Generate Intro. Look where I am. Generate Intro. And it tells me, a window comes up. And the window says, do you want jazz chord types for this song? Yes. My introduction bar length. How long do I want it to go? Well, it'll tell you, right, two bars, whether you want two bars or four bars or eight bars. And notice it's got some recommendations there. Two bars for slow tunes, four bars for a medium tempo soon, and eight bars for a faster tempo soon. Why would that be? Well, probably they're intelligent enough when they put this together to know that most slow songs need to get on with it, right? You know, can have these long drawn out intros, you know. I mean, like I said before, there are no TikTok days, 15 seconds, right? But two bars, at the max, four bars is long enough for a ballad, right? A medium tempo song might be, again, you can do four bars, right? Eight bars for a fast song, because that's probably more a groove based, whatever type of groove it is, right? Funk, country, whatever. It's more groove based, and eight bars allows people to get more into the groove. But of course, usually if it's a ballad, a slow song, right, it's more of probably about the singer. So I decided to select two bars here, right? So I'm going to do two bars. Notice the key is in the key, the same key. I want it in the same key. And that's all I need to mess with right now. And I'm going to generate an intro and see what it sounds like. So I hit generate an intro, right? And I'm going to close this window. And now notice I ended up picking up two bars, right? So let's play these two bars and see what they sound like. Kind of nice. like that. What I don't like about it, though, is that, again, what did I not want to do? I didn't want to hit people in the face with the background vocals right off the bat, right? So what am I going to do? I like the intro, but I don't like the background vocals starting the song. So I'm going to go into my bar settings, right-click in the chord, in the bar. I'm going to go to my bar settings. Bar settings is here. And I'm going to mute. I'm going to mute the vocals, the vocal oohs, and I'm going to mute the vocal ahs, which is what I just did. So now when I generate, they're not going to play until bar three. So I've got two bars with nothing but music. And I love that sound. It's nice and smooth. Now they come in, which I think is a much better setup for the song. Now notice that when it generated an intro for me, right, it gave me four chords, even though my initial intro would have had, in the first two bars, it would have only had one chord. But Band in a Box decided through its intelligence that a four chord, two bar intro would be good for it, right? So I said, okay, well, let me try it and see. And I like the way it sounded. Well, now what I can do also is, maybe I didn't like that intro, right? I can go back to song form, generate intro, and regenerate another intro. So if I regenerate another intro, now it's regenerated another intro. And notice these chords have changed, right? And now if I play them, it could be totally, totally different than before, which is different. Actually, I like that one even better. Didn't like the last chord too much, though, you know. But that just goes to show you the intelligence that's built inside of the product, right? So again, if you're struggling for an intro, then go to song form, go to generate intro, pick the type of chords you want, pick the number of bars you want for your intro, and just generate. And you'd be surprised at the results that you'll get. And just to show you a difference that doing that made, remember now, I was gonna start the song from right here. That's why I was gonna start the song from when I first wrote the song out, right? But again, by just having this nice feature of generating an intro, right, it allowed some creativity on my part and on the system's part to give me two bars to set those ahs up. So now if I play the song based on my final mix of the song, it's a huge difference overall. Excuse me. And that's long enough for an intro. And when I say intro, I'm talking about no vocals. excuse me. It's all got me excited, right?
I still hear the sounds of the children playing and the shouting from down the hall. I can hear what they're saying.
So again, that just gives you an idea of how you can be creative by using the features available to you inside of the Band in a Box product to help you out, to give you something different, to give you something that you may not have thought of before. So again, so all I wanted to tell you guys today, and I know, MIDI part two, I'm telling you, I'm having trouble scripting that thing and working it out, but I will get to it. But anyway, I thought I'd put this together. It's relatively quick, and it just gives you an idea of how you can incorporate intros into your songs. And also, before I go, I still see a lot of people asking the system being quirky because they're using repeats. Notice that my thing is set to one chorus and 70 bars. I don't do any repeats. I don't care for them. Unfold the song, write the song from start to finish. I guarantee you, you will be much more pleased with the results than putting in a bunch of bar settings. Because believe me, especially if you're trying to do things like bringing instruments in and out, Because if you bring them in and out, right, then if you're using bar settings, remember, it's going to repeat that exact same flow of in and out instruments, and you may not want that throughout the song. You may not want a certain guitar in the first half of the song, but you may want it in the second half of the song. But because you use bar settings, repeats, and codas and things like that, right, it's going to play the same thing over again. But anyway, that's another subject altogether, and I actually did address that in another video. So again, this is about intros, generating an intro. Hope you guys had time to check this out. Hope you get a chance to experiment with it, and I will see you guys next time. Bye.